morning. So, today is Wednesday. Today is surgery day. Not for me, but for Ginger. Today she's getting spayed. Woke up this morning, got ready for the gym, got her ready, put her in the car. I put my little mosaic letters that I had since my grad party, the RN letters, put those in the car because I really need to take them to my storage unit. Long story short, I'm on my way to drop off Ginger at her surgery. And today I'm gonna be doing a day in the life of a new grad nurse. And this is crazy because it's my first like day in the life of a new grad nurse. So I thought that was pretty cool. So just come along with me for the day. After I drop her off to her spay appointment, I'm gonna go to the gym. And then after I go to the gym, I am gonna do some other things and keep you guys updated. Ginger, you ready to go? My Ginger. Nervous for her. I'm nervous for you, boo. I'm at my storage unit because I had to put some of the stuff that was from my party in here because I don't feel like I need to give this away. It's a big poster of me and it says Sierra Car BSN coming to a hospital near you. This is something that you hold on to forever, I think. I also have all this stuff that I had from my party that I used to decorate. It looks a little ghetto because some of it fell in the bag, but like I had these test tubes for like samples and stuff like that. These test tubes that I had med cups. I had syringes for jello shots. These little med cups, and I put Smarties in there, like take your meds. And I also had urine sample cups, but I used them as stool sample cups, and I put Oreos in here and I like labeled it stool samples. So I had like a lot of cool stuff for my party. I'm kind of mad because I really didn't get a lot of footage of my party now that I think back to it. I also have like these IV bags. We had IV bags and I infused them with little alcohol seltzers. So I used the syringe. I pretty much like drew it out of the can and then put it in the IV bag. And we had like those as like normal saline, LR, lactated ringers and stuff like that. So those were the IV bags. And then we also had an alcoholic IV bag with like red juice in it and fruit punch. And it was like blood bags or like whole red blood. So we had a lot of cute stuff. And I just don't want to get rid of it because I feel like that would be a waste. But like also keeping it is a waste because I have no use for it now. I just don't know what to do with them. Honestly, if one of you guys wants to take all this stuff, I will gladly send it to you. And I also want to decorate these big letters. Someone gave me a really good idea and said that I should fill them with flowers because they were filled with balloons for my party and had RN on them. But someone said that I should definitely fill them with flowers, and I definitely would do that. And if someone would want to buy it, I would give it to you. I'm definitely not the type to like sell stuff for like an expensive price. Like I just want to do the project because it's fun and then I'll like give it to you for a cheap price. So done with that. Now I need to go get an oil change. The oil shop is like literally right next door. So it's only going to take like 5 to 10 minutes. Then I'm going to go to the gym. Doing all this running around this morning. On my days off, it's literally just like errands. I'm running errands all day. Just finished a really good workout. I was drenched with a T in sweat. I ran a mile, a little over a mile, and I have finally got my mile back under 15 minutes, which is good. I want to get under 10 minutes, but you know, I'll take under 15 for now. And then I did the Stairmaster for like 30 minutes and I did 100 flights of stairs and I burned like over 300 calories. All of this is good. All of this is great. Oh my God, I am so sweaty. So now that I got that out the way, I'm about to go to a coffee shop and study Mark Klimek's lecture. I haven't made a schedule yet or anything. I really need to, like an actual calendar, but I haven't been able to schedule my NCLEX yet because my school has not given us authorization to test. So after you graduate, your school is supposed to submit the AOG, which is like proof of graduation, to the board of nursing in whatever state you're in. So my school did not do that yet, and we are almost like probably one of the few schools, nursing schools, that has not submitted it yet, and a lot of other schools are already able to schedule their NCLEX. So that's kind of frustrating. But of course, like, I feel like all nursing schools have, like, they're unorganized, and I don't know, so they're just super behind, and we're in the process of getting a new, like, dean of nursing per se, or like director of nursing at our campus. So like within the switchover, I'm sure there's like, you know, a lot to be done, but that's besides the fact, because we have to literally take our NCLEX and we only get so long before our start date. And if some residencies only allow you to start if you've already got your NCLEX and you're a registered nurse. So that's a little frustrating because, yeah, like, I need to have my authorization to test. So once they submit the AOG, it takes 2 weeks, then you get authorization to test and you can schedule your NCLEX. And since they have not submitted that, we are not able to schedule our NCLEX. And so I am hoping to take it. I wanted to take it literally like by the end of June, but now it's looking like I'm gonna be taking it. Looks like I'm gonna be taking it in July. Ciao, not you working out. You on the Stairmaster? I just got off the Stairmaster. Child, I was sweating. Sweating. Say hey to the vlog. Well, they can't hear you. I got my AirPods. Okay, so that was my cousin. But anyway, I'm on my way to the coffee shop so I can start studying the next two Mark Klimek lectures. And then by the end of the day, I want to get through another 75 UWorld questions. And I kind of want to do this at least like almost every day, so that I'm just getting everything down and I will be ready to take the NCLEX, because time is flying by and I really only want to take the NCLEX one time, period. And it's like $200 to take the NCLEX. So, and now that my time is like a little pushed off even more because they're taking forever to submit our AOG to get our ATT, authorization to test, yeah, like I can really only take it one time, because if I have to take it at the beginning of July, which I can't because I'm going out of town. I mean, unless I take it before then, which is going to be great, but like it takes 9 days to get your results. So if I were to take it at the beginning of July, and I don't know, it's just a hot mess. So anyway, long story short, hoping for the best. Hopefully I will be able to take my NCLEX at a decent time, go on my trip, and then chill before I start my residency. So it's all super exciting, but that's what I'm about to do. I have not had coffee in a week, so today I'm gonna treat myself to a coffee shop and get a cup of coffee, maybe a cappuccino. And yeah, and I know it's kind of gross that I'm not getting in the shower as soon as I leave the gym, but it's best for me to be out, get everything done that I need to get done, and then go back home, because if I go back home, get in the shower, baby, I won't be studying Mark's lectures. That shit's when it ends. I won't be studying Mark's lectures. No. No. It won't get done. So, I have to do it this way. I just picked Ginger up from surgery. She looks so tired. Yeah, my Ginger. Bro, she's so cute though. So, made it home. Ginger is so tired. She's not happy at all. She's pissed actually. They said that she can have a little bit of food after 7 p.m. She can have a little bit of water. She does not want to drink water. She hasn't peed at all, and she was supposed to pee, but every time I put her down in the grass, she just stands there because she doesn't want to move. She's never had a cone on her head before, so she's kind of like trying to figure it out. Today was a pretty good day. I did a lot today. After I studied, I went and got my nails done. So I went for like a light I'd say maybe like a cotton candy pink. And it definitely looks like a cotton candy pink, but when she was first doing it, it did not look like a cotton candy pink. It looked more like a bubblegum pink, and I was not into it. But now it looks really cute. And they were definitely talking about my toes. I don't know why, because I don't think my toes are that bad. They just like regular toes to me. Uh-oh, it's chipped a little bit already, but anyway. Went and got my nails done. After that, I took my little brother to track practice, picked up some food, ate that, and now here I am. So the day has been super busy, and this is kind of how it's been since not having like much of an agenda, especially on my days that I'm off. I have been really into working out in the mornings and studying immediately after I get done working out, because if I come home, get in the shower, I like postpone studying and it's just not good. So I go study at a coffee shop, which I did. I kind of want to tell you guys about Mark Kay's lectures that I've been studying and how I've been doing my notes. So here's pretty much how it is. I bought this notebook at Target. It was only like $8.99, and it's really cute because it has like the little bears on it. And honestly, I realized before I started studying, I'm like, I need to go back to the old school way that I used to study and retain everything. Like, I remember pre-nursing school, I would write all my notes down, I would highlight them the same every single time, and it was just the best way for me to learn and memorize things. And I kind of did that as well, like in nursing school. Like, I remember in peds, I would like write down everything and highlight everything, and it was super easy to remember all the information. So I'm doing the same for the NCLEX because I really want to keep a continuum of things so I can ace this thing in 75 questions. So fingers crossed on that. But all of my headings are blue, and it'll say what number lecture it is. And then all the topics are pink, and then the subtopics are orange. And then important information is yellow. And then everything that Mark has said is in green. And so everything that he says that like helps remember something, or everything that I find like, you know, easier to remember, I always put it in green. Like, they deny, you confront. He said that. He said the number one problem of alcohol abusers is denial. So everything that he specifically has said is in green. And then the topics, he'll be like, okay, we're going to talk about denial treatment. Or he'll be like, okay, next we're going to talk about dependency, codependency. And that's what I write. And then like of the notes that he, the things that he says, like I'll write down in yellow, or I'll write down and then I'll highlight in yellow if I just feel like it's important information. These were prior notes that I took. Today I went over, so cardiac drugs was the last one I went over, and that was pretty long. He had a lot of information over that. But the most recent one I finished, I went ahead and finished his third, was it the third lecture? His third lecture, and that was over cardiac and drugs and chest tubes. So today I finished information over chest tubes, so troubleshooting chest tubes, what happens if the water seal breaks, what happens if the chest tube comes out, what happens if there's bubbling in the chest tube. All these green things are important things that he said. Water seal versus suction control is opposite. So like if the water seal breaks, if it's intermittent, it's good. If it's continuous, that's bad. Versus in suction control, intermittent is bad and continuous is good. So it's opposite. And he also said a straight catheter is to a Foley as to a thoracentesis is to a chest tube. And like if you watch his videos, you definitely understand. And that's why I have this method of writing everything down, especially in green, and kind of remembering all those things. We also went over heart defects, congenital heart defects, which I loved this topic in peds. I specifically remember like loving congenital heart defects, and me and Anosha were studying. I was trying to help her understand like the congenital defects and get them all down, because I just kind of love them. And as y'all have learned, that I love the heart. Like, I love everything about the heart. When I did my peds rotation and I was able to go to the CVICU, the cardiovascular ICU, it was wonderful. I loved it. And like, once you understand the heart, it just all makes sense. So I really enjoyed this. He made it super easy. Something, if you are studying for your NCLEX and you have not yet listened to Marque's lectures, pretty much he made it super easy. Every defect is either trouble or it's no trouble, especially when you're a baby. And pretty much if it shunts from right to left, that's trouble. Everything that you're going to talk to the parents is trouble. Your kid might need surgery. Your kid might not survive. Your kid might need this. Your kid might need this. Versus if there's a left to right shunt, it's all right. He might need surgery down the line, but right now he's good. He'll be fine. And then another important thing to remember, which is super easy, all the heart defects that start with a T are no good. They are not good. They are bad. So tetralogy of Fallot, truncus arteriosus, tricuspid atresia, all this stuff is really bad. And that's one way that you know that it shunts from right to left and it is trouble and it is really bad and they're going to need surgery and their kid is going to be failure to thrive and all these things that are life-threatening. So that's really good. Went over tetralogy of Fallot, contact isolation, all the infectious disease and transmission-based precautions. And then I also went ahead and went over the canes, crutches, walkers, and psych patients. And that is it so far. So right now I am on his fifth lecture. And honestly, I feel like I need to speed it up a little bit because doing two a day might be a little better just so I can go ahead and get going on UWorld and get that stuff out of the way and really be prepared because they just sent us a message about our authorization to test and it should be done by the end of the week, which I'm not being hopeful for. I'm going to say the beginning of next week because it already is about to be Friday. So hopefully we'll get that soon and I'll be able to schedule my NCLEX. But anyway, so that is all about Mark K and how I've been studying for the NCLEX so far. I also wanted to show these to y'all earlier. I am sitting outside just kind of enjoying the vibe. The weather's really nice today. These are the like IV bags that I had at my graduation party and it is getting really dark out here, so I'm really sorry. I put like little seltzers in them. I'm just gonna sip on this a little bit. And one last thing that I wanted to do before the night is done is definitely write out my calendar for the month of June. Because it is now June. So, I'm gonna go ahead and write out my work schedule and everything that I have to get done this week. For the month of June. And then that's pretty much is going to be it for this week's video. I'm probably gonna go upstairs and do some UWorld questions and get ready for work tomorrow. So that is that. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this week's video. I know it's been so long since I've seen y'all and I missed y'all, and I hope you guys enjoyed this one. I definitely need to get back on doing weekly vlogs for you guys, especially now that I'm out of nursing school. Like, I feel like there has been a weight lifted off my shoulders. Like, I feel just so much more happier and lightweight and just ready to go out and do all the things that make me happy. So thank you guys for watching again. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe if you're not already a subscriber. Hit that subscribe button. I love y'all. It's taking me forever to hit 10k, so y'all need to go ahead and subscribe to my channel if you like it. Don't forget to always be kind, love yourself and others, and always go out and try your best. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.